Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. We're doing negative exponents today, and the general idea for a negative exponent is that if an exponent is negative, if you want to make it positive, you put that into the denominator. It's 1 over that. So if you think about the negative exponent causes the base to change places in the fraction, think about it this way. This started off in the numerator, even though we didn't see it. And so when it becomes, to simplify that to become positive, we put it in the denominator. Once it drops down, that power goes from negative to positive. And of course, we have to put something on top, which is where the 1 comes in. Let's look at 3 examples where we can use the this rule. The first one looks like the first one up here, a to the negative third becomes 1 over a to the third, and that's because it really was in the numerator and it moved to the denominator. For the second one, we have x to the negative fifth, which is in the denominator, so when it changes, it's going to go to the numerator. Think about it as over 1, even though we don't need to show it. So in part C, we can see that the m to the negative 2 that was on the top, it shifts to the bottom, and the x to the negative y that was on the bottom shifts to the top. So we can move anything that's got a negative exponent. We just move its place, change its place in the fraction, and when we do, the power becomes positive. But remember, other exponent rules still apply, so you don't want to be forgetting those. Let's look at these 2 problems. Remember the exponent rule that says if you have 2 factors raised to a power, they both go to a power? So I can simplify this in a few different ways, and I'm going to do it this way. First, remember this rule that says what we really have here is x to the negative third and y to the negative third. But this is all over 1, and because I have negative exponents, those things have to be shifted down. In general, besides if we work with scientific notation, the rest of the time we want positive exponents only. So when those shift, they're leaving a 1 up on top. They don't leave a 0, they leave a 1. And I have x to the third and y to the third. I could also have talked about this in this way. This is like over 1, and I'm going to shift the whole thing down and have x to the y to the third power. But that's not fully simplified unless you distribute it through. So I like this answer better. Okay, what about this one? Well, I could start shifting things around, but there's a rule to the exponent that says if you raise a power to a power, you multiply. So I'm going to do that. Negative 3 times negative 5 is positive 15. Now I don't even have a negative to worry about. That's it. Let's look at 2 more examples. When I want to simplify something with the same base, remember the rule, we subtract the exponents. So you can do it that way. You can say this is actually p to the 7th minus negative 5. We're subtracting a negative. That's how we get p to the 12th, right? That was just written poorly. But the other way to think about this is because this is negative, it's going to go up. Now, p to the 7th is positive. It's not going anywhere. But p to the negative 5 comes up, and now it's up there on the same level with p to the 7th, and now we can see another way to get p to the 12th. One way was to subtract these 2. The other way is to move that negative exponent and then simplify, which is what I like to do. Also, we always have to think about the coefficients out front, and so 15 divided by 3 is 5. That's still going to happen no matter what's following that. This is power 1. There's no negative exponents attached to that. The negative exponent is attached to the x. So I know that x to the negative 3 is going to go down and x to the negative 5 is going to go up. So I have 15 x to the 5th over 3 x to the 3rd. Those 2 negative exponents swapped places because they move place in the fraction. 15 divided by 3 is 5, and I have more x's on top. Again, if I use this rule where I subtract, 5 minus 3 is 2, I have more x's on top by 2, and that's going to be my final answer. Negative coefficients do not move bases. Negative powers move bases. Remember, the coefficient is the number out front. So I want you to see this one. When people see this after they've started moving things with negatives, they want to drop this negative 5 down. That's not Not anything, no rule that I'm telling you. This power is 1. That's positive. It's not going anywhere. This also is positive. It's not going anywhere. If I wanted to simplify this to get rid of the negatives, I would just move that one term. And I would have negative 5 still on the top. And I would have x to the positive 3 and y to the positive 3. Doesn't really matter the order there, but usually we write things alphabetically. Okay, same thing here, negative 20 over 4. I'm not moving anything. I'm simplifying that, but I'm not moving that because it's got positive powers here. It's not about the negative being part of the coefficient. Y to the negative third is going to drop down and become y to the positive third. And I'm going to simplify the rest of this. So negative 20 divided by 4 is negative 5, which is totally acceptable. And then I have, where do I have more x's? Well, I have more on top. This is like 2 minus 1, so I have one extra x on top. Y to the negative 3 drops down and becomes y to the positive 3, and that's my simplified version. Okay, so just be careful of that. And the last two problems I want to show you, this is just similar to the one we did earlier. I can bring this whole thing up because this is to a negative 3. I can bring this up to be 5b to the third power. And I could simplify that to be 5 to the third and b to the third. And if they wanted it to multiply that out, that's 125b to the third. But because this was in the denominator, it goes up to the top. This one. All right, everybody take note. This kind of thing is on your final, and people miss it a lot. Here I'm going to do a rule that I did earlier, that is multiply these two powers. And so I get x to the 21st over x to the negative 6. And now I'm going to use that other rule that I used up here where I was subtracting. What I have is x to the 21st minus negative 6. Or I can shift this and say what I have is x to the 21st, x to the 6th, and either way I can see it's 21 plus 6, which is x to the 27th power. So multiply and then move your negative exponents and then add if they're on the same level. Or you can, instead of moving, you can just subtract, but remember you're subtracting a negative 6. Okay, that's negative exponents. I'll see you next time.